In our project, InDivEU, we explore what role differentiated integration may play in the future of European integration. We are doing this by asking experts and practitioners about their assessment of the pros and cons of differentiated integration. And to this end, we are organizing 7 stakeholder workshops with participants from across the European Union.
The starting point in these forums is the European Commission's white paper that was released in 2017 against the backdrop of multiple crises surrounding the EU and of a popular discontent on the performance of the European Union. The white paper was intended to initiate a serious debate on the fundamental issues of European integration. What are the objectives of European integration and what type of integration is best suited to meet these objectives?
The white paper provides 5 different scenarios on the future of Europe. Scenario 1, carrying on. Scenario 2, nothing but the single market. Scenario 3, those who want more, do more. Scenario 4, doing less, more efficiently. And scenario 5, doing much more together.
Scenario 3 is the one we will focus on during our workshop. It is a scenario in which the EU would pursue differentiated integration. So let's look at what scenario 3 means in detail. In this scenario, certain member states could decide to do more together. As a result, one or several coalitions of the willing would emerge in order to work together in some specific policy areas, such as internal security, taxation, or social matters.
These new groups of countries would agree on specific legal and budgetary arrangements to deepen their cooperation in the policy domains they choose.
At the same time, the status of the other member states would be preserved, and they would have the possibility of joining the group of frontrunners at a later stage.
Now, what does the white paper say about the impact of differentiated integration on European policies?
The EU single market may be strengthened as the EU27 may pursue progressive trade agreements. In the economic and monetary union, some member states may decide to deepen their cooperation in fields such as taxation or social matters.
Regarding Schengen, migration and security, a group of countries may deepen cooperation on security and justice matters.
Finally, in foreign policy, some member states may decide to integrate more in the field of defense. In all these cases, additional budgets would be made available by the participating member states for the chosen policy domains. As a result, the EU's capacity to deliver would increase, but at the same time, the decision-making process would also become more complex.
In this workshop, we want to hear your views on the pros and cons of differentiation. In particular, we want you to assess the feasibility, desirability, and the sustainability of the European Commission's scenario for differentiated integration.
By feasibility, we mean how likely it is that differentiated integration will become a more central feature of European integration in the future. By desirability, we mean how desirable differentiated integration is, considering all its positive and negative consequences for the EU, for the member states, but also for the citizens.
By sustainability, we mean how stable will a highly differentiated European Union be? Will it tend towards uniform integration or towards disintegration? We would like you to consider 4 different forms of differentiated integration, which you have heard about in our first video. The first form is high internal differentiation, meaning that there would be a multitude of overlapping policy regimes between the member states of the European Union.
Second, a high external differentiated integration, meaning that some non-EU members would follow the rules of the EU and would have rights and obligations. Third, a multi-speed differentiated integration, meaning that differentiation would only be temporary and that ultimately all the member states would tend to the same end goal.
The last form we want you to consider is a European Union of multiple endpoints, meaning that differentiation is permanent and the member states do not aspire to an ever closer union.
So to conclude, stay informed and explore the different documents on the InDivEU website. Share your opinion by using the InDivEU interactive document and by filling a short pre-workshop questionnaire. And finally, we look forward to discussing the pros and cons of differentiated integration with you at the workshop.
Thank you for watching this video. We are looking forward to discussing the pros and cons of differentiated integration at our workshop.